Hi, can you tell us your names and what course you teach?
I'm Steve Lerman.
And I'm Judd Harward.
And we teach course 100, which in MIT is Introduction to Computation and Engineering Problem Solving.
And can you tell us what are the goals of this particular class?
The course is designed for students who are not majoring in computer science but need to have a basic comprehension of computational methods and computer programming. So we draw students from all the departments of MIT. Even once in a while a computer science major takes the course. So our goals are to teach students about computing, teach them a programming language, and introduce them to some introductory algorithms in several different areas.
So what happens on a daily basis in class?
We used to teach it as a standard lecture and problem set course, but we found that many of the students would delay until the night before the problem set to really come to grips with the material, often in the wee hours of the morning. And so, inspired by colleagues in physics, we tried to incorporate active learning techniques in the course. So in an average week, we'll have 1 to 2 standard lectures, but we'll also have at least one session where, after presenting the material, we then ask the students to work through a problem while we're available to answer questions, and the TAs in the course circulate too. And in working out the problem, very often that involves programming, so we've introduced the use of laptops in class.
So is it a small group type of structure then, or how does the lecture versus the small group aspect of it work?
Well, both those activities take place in a lecture-style hall, but the students are doing very different things. In a lecture, it's very traditional. One of us is in front of the class for sustained periods of time teaching the students. In the active learning, we typically pose a problem, and those of you who look at the OpenCourseWare site will see notes where we switch to that mode. And the students are solving guided problems, and then Judd and I and our teaching assistants are wandering around the room, looking over people's shoulders and helping them get through the guided exercises. And then we'll talk about them. We'll reassemble everybody in more lecture style to have a discussion about what that assignment was about. And that might go back and forth several times within the course of an active learning session.
Okay, so how are students assessed in this area? Is it mostly on their coding assignments? Are there also exams and quizzes? Or can you say more about that?
There are exams and quizzes, but nobody programs best under pressure. So the problem sets, we feel, are a more reliable means of assessing the students. And actually, we think a lot of the learning in the course comes from working through those problem sets. So by the end of the course, we actually combine two problem sets over 2 or 3 weeks, where we asked the students in the first problem set to plan a much more major assignment, and we pair them up so they're working in teams, and then they code their own design for the final problem set of the course.
And what size teams would they be working in?
We usually use teams of 2. It's always a trade-off. Larger teams could do bigger projects, but then the logistics, particularly at the end of a busy semester, of the students getting together to cooperate, turn out to be complicated. So we've decided on teams of 2. Occasionally we'll have a team of 3, or in some rare cases, someone will just do the assignment on his or her own.
Actually, the undergraduates in management who are taught to work in teams, they've sometimes asked to work in teams of 3 because they're used to it.
Okay. Now, are there any other special course elements, such as field trips or guest lecturers or anything like that, that you incorporate?
No, the course is, in that sense, pretty traditional. Most of the activities happen either in class. We do have tutorial sessions. So in addition to 4 to 5 hours of in-class time with one of us, the teaching assistants take small groups, usually 10 to 12 students, and spend an hour a week in a much more interactive style where they can talk much more closer to one-on-one. And then we all have extensive office hours where we meet individually with students.
If there's a problem set that the students have particularly enjoyed, sometimes we have a competition. We had them program the Game of Life a couple of years ago, and we had a competition to see who could add the most interesting features to the game.
Now, is there anything else that's sort of unique or special about the class that you haven't talked about so far?
Well, we're part of a group of courses at MIT that are experimenting with laptops in the classroom. Right now, MIT doesn't have a laptop requirement, so all students don't have laptops. Many do, of course, a growing fraction buy them on their own. So we ask them, those who have them, to bring them to class. We loan students who don't have them laptops. And many of the exercises require using the laptop in the class, and as well as being used outside the class.
Okay. Any final thoughts?
Well, one thing to emphasize about this course is, while right now we teach it in the Java language and the OpenCourseWare site reflects the notes, we've actually taught it over time in many different languages. A central element of the course is it really isn't about the programming language. They learn the programming language, but it's really about algorithmic design, reusable code modules, the notion of object-oriented programming. And I personally have taught it in, I think, 4 or 5 different languages over the last 25 years.
Okay. Well, thank you very much for participating in OpenCourseWare. We really appreciate your input.
Thank you.
Thank you.